Hello, Christians. Hope you all are fine and well at your places. I have come again with a beautiful story of Dashera. On this day, we lit the effigy of Ravan. So, why do we lit the effigy of Ravan? We will come to know by this beautiful story. So, get ready to enjoy this story of Dashera.
Once upon a time in Ayodhya ruled the mighty king Dashrath. He was blessed with four brave sons, Ram, Lakshman, Shatrughan and Bharat. Ram the oldest was loved by all, except Kekai, Ram's wicked stepmother. She said to Dashrath, "You promised me two boons. My son Bharat must be the new king, and the second one is that send Ram for 14 years to the forest." Dashrath was bound to uphold the promise. Ram was calm and consoled the king. "Father, my duty is clear. You must keep your word to Queen Kekai." Next day, Ram, Sita and his brother Lakshman left the royal palace behind. All of Ayodhya bid them farewell. Tears streamed down most faces. How could the three used to palaces survive Dandaka forest, the darkest of places? The three settled down to a simple life, but a terrible fate lay ahead of them. One day, when the brothers were away, Ravana came disguised as a beggar. He pretended to ask Sita for food and tricked her out of her shelter. Throwing Sita onto Pushpak, his magical chariot, swiftly towards Lanka did Ravana make his way, for that was his kingdom far across the ocean where he and his mighty demon army held sway. On seeing that Ravana had kidnapped Sita and was flying off with her in the sky, Jatayu had challenged Ravana to a fight, but was cut down and left there to die.
"Ravan has taken Sita to Lanka," said Jatayu.
Ram and Lakshman set off to Lanka at once. Passing through Kishkindha, the monkey kingdom, there they luckily met the mighty general Hanuman, who was renowned for his bravery and wisdom. On hearing of Ravan's evil deed, an army of monkeys and bears was raised. They built a bridge to reach Lanka's shore. There a vast army stood ready and armed, and so began a most fearsome war. People say that such a great battle had never been fought before. The monkey warriors were quick and fought with courage and skill. Ram's and Lakshman's magical arrows did thousands of damage skill. The demons too fought with valor, and never did they seem to tire. They fell upon the monkey army and did fight fire with fire. Finally, Ram and Ravan met, and a fearsome duel did ensue. Ram's arrow cut off Ravan's head, but in its place a new one grew. 10 times did Ram cut off Ravan's head, and 10 times a new one sprang up in its stead. Ram then remembered that his navel was where Ravan's life force did flow. Picking out a flaming golden arrow, he carefully released it from his bow. As the arrow hit Ravan's navel, time seemed to stand still. Very slowly he fell to the ground. The evil demon was finally killed. Victory was Ram's as Ravan lay dead, as Rama and Sita embraced each other. The 14 years of Ram's exile had also finally come to an end. Carrying the three on his mighty shoulders, Hanuman flew to Ayodhya that very night. Ram was crowned king of Ayodhya. It was a joyous celebration. So, this was the story of the Dashera festival. Hope you have liked this story, students. Thank you so much.